I'm Greg Grugan in Houston.
I'm Rudy Koski in Austin.
And I'm Stephen Dial in Dallas, and this is Texas The Issue Is.
This week I talked in depth with Democrat for Texas Attorney General Rochelle Garza, who laid out her case for replacing controversial incumbent Ken Paxton. How did being the daughter of educators and the sister of a special needs brother form your worldview?
It formed everything for me. You know, I grew up learning advocacy at home. I grew up learning what it meant to treat everyone with dignity and respect. That's why I have become a civil rights lawyer. That's why I fought for people that have been overlooked and left behind by our legal system, because I truly believe that we are all equal under the law.
Rochelle, you've talked to thousands of Texans since the Dobbs decision. What are women telling you? What are Texans telling you?
And I hear these stories of heartache and fear about what the future holds, but also these really difficult decisions that people are facing. I received a letter from a mother who was pregnant with twins and had to leave the state because one of her twins was not viable. And this was clearly a very wanted pregnancy. I've spoken with physicians who are so afraid to provide care and are concerned about the state of the medical field in Texas. I'm a mother. I have a 6-month-old daughter. Roe fell when she was 3 months old on her 3-month birthday. And I remember looking at her and just feeling so heartbroken for the future about whether or not she would be able to control her own body and her own future. And that's why this fight is so important for so many Texans. It's about our lives. That's why I'm in this fight, to make sure that we unseat not only a criminally indicted attorney general, but someone who has sued to stop doctors from providing life-saving care to people who need abortions in our state.
If elected attorney general, how could you provide Texas women more protection than they have now?
Well, when I'm elected attorney general, when I become the attorney general of Texas, I am going to use the independent constitutional power of this office to protect Texans from these extreme abortion bans. And I'll have the power to do it. I can partner with district attorneys across the state of Texas to fight to protect reproductive rights in state courts. And I can make sure that we are not forcing doctors to second guess the care that they're giving for fear of going to prison for life or losing their medical license. That's my commitment. I am not going to stop fighting until we restore abortion access in this state.
When it comes to our border with Mexico, it's not a new issue for you. You grew up there. Yeah. You understand the challenges, and you've seen what's gone on. How could you make it better?
So we can absolutely protect people, stop human trafficking, stop gun trafficking, stop drugs from coming into this country that are destroying lives. We can do that. But we also can treat people humanely.
Is President Biden doing enough in the border?
Frankly, no. I think the federal government needs to do a lot more work to ensure an orderly immigration system and ensure that people are treated with dignity. I also recognize that our border communities are bearing the brunt of this. We need to give them support. Border communities are typically the most impoverished in our state. So let's make sure that our communities have resources. And as Attorney General, I will hold the federal government accountable for doing their job, because we shouldn't have to bear the brunt of it as Texans.
How did Paxton fail us before the grid failed and after?
You know, Paxton didn't do anything to hold anyone accountable. These energy companies put their losses on the consumers. And so we are being forced to pay back those losses over time. So in part, that is why you're seeing an increase in your energy bill. So we need to stop that. We need to make sure that we have an attorney general who will look into that, investigate, and hold people accountable.
The president has made a significant move in pardoning thousands of prisoners within the federal system for crimes involving simple possession of marijuana. Your reaction to that?
I think it's really important that we move towards legalizing cannabis. So legalizing cannabis in Texas is a $1 billion industry, and we can fund public schools. We can reinvigorate rural Texas.
If you could teach your daughter one lesson, what would that be?
Don't ever let anyone underestimate you, because you can make real change. Doesn't matter how small you are or where you live, you can have a huge impact.
What would it mean to have a Latina as the top lawyer for the people of the Lone Star State?
This is the people's lawyer, and we're going to return it to the people of Texas.
All right, my one-word response, firewall. Steven, how about you?
I'm going to say new blood. We'll get into it later, but she's the different type of candidate that the Democratic Party will need moving forward.
Okay, Kosky, lay it on me in one word.
My word, sedition.
Okay, stay with us. The Fox Texas Trio is set to drill down on Garza's positions and prospects on the other side of this break.